Hello everyone, welcome to Artel Studio, and today we are going to do the painting on Pichhwai art again. We are doing a continuation of the painting. So wherein in one painting we see a lot of elements, we will be going further with the different elements and incorporate it to make it a beautiful one. So if you all can hear me, please type in a yes so that I get assured on the video and the audio. So if you, good afternoon Deep, good afternoon Vaishnavi. Hello Mehak, hello everyone. So as in when you come, please type in a yes or a hi so that I get to know who all are there with me. And yes, it's a pleasure to see you all attending all the classes and being very regular in the art. So that's nice. Good afternoon Mehak. So if you can hear me very well, please type a yes. I'm waiting for a yes and then I will be starting with the work of today. For those who are new today, I would be again repeating, Pichhwai art is the art form from Rajasthan, which means the pitch is the backside and vai means the hanging. So it is done, a painting is done on the cloth, and those cloth textiles were being hung behind the idol of Shrinathji in Nathdwara. Okay, thank you. Yes, so I got a yes from Deep, he can hear me. So we will start with today's picture. So when you look at a Pichhwai painting, you will see that it is not only one main thing that is in the middle. There is a whole setting and the perspective is very high. So the importance on the element, each and every element is shared equally. So whatever the setting is, whatever the elements are, be it trees, be it peacock, be it cow, be it lotuses, bond, the scenery, anything that is there adds to the beauty of a Pichhwai, and Pichhwai is known for its very high detailed work. Few Pichhwais now these days, they are done so elaborately that people start comparing it with miniature paintings. Like in my yesterday's session also, there was a doubt on what is miniature painting and what is Pichhwai. So Pichhwais are, I'm repeating the same thing today, that Pichhwai is generally big and not very, very small. Now people have taken started taking one small element and painting it and adorning the houses or their home decor items. They are doing it in small contemporary style. But if we talk about Pichhwai, Pichhwai is like 6 to 7 feet in size. It's a very big and done on a cloth. Though the detailing is very high, we see that the detailing is very high, but the figures are not miniature. The elements are not miniature. Miniature means very small. Now, miniature forms are very much seen in the Mughal style of painting, where Mughal style of painting, now here also we see that Kishangarh style, then Nathdwara style, they are different styles. And when we study the how to make the figures with very distinct, very light, slight changes in the shape of the eyes, the nose, the point of the nose, we can make out which school of art it follows. So with what style it follows. So that is the main thing. But yes, all of them are covered in one big umbrella, and that is Pichhwai art. There are various forms, various themes and various subjects related to Pichhwai art. So there are still few more videos to come. As I promised, I couldn't do that. But yes, I will be showing you here today. I'll place it on my table. And yesterday we did a peacock. Now here, this was a peacock that we did yesterday, and this was just above the Kamal Talai that we did. I have shown it to you previously. Now that is the bottom. Now here I am giving a little perspective to my painting. What I have taken is the green, a little green, and then I will be gradually making three shades. So this is the palette, and here taking some white. If you mix white with green, you will definitely get a different shade. If you mix yellow with green, you will get a different shade. You can just check onto your So I've taken white also, and I've taken somewhere yellow also. Now here I will create some, you can draw also. You can use your pencil to draw it. Here I'm using just the brush. I actually chalked out the idea what I have to, because we don't have any reference here. You have to build your own. So I just tried figuring out what, how my picture will move. So I, as I made it yesterday, I made this peacock stand on a hill or a flat land. Followed by it, I will be giving some hill kind of things here. So here giving, so that we get to see that, okay, this is the source where the water is coming and then filling down in the pond where I have already made this. So I'll just pull it a little so that you can see. So this is the pond we've already discussed and made it. And this is the landform. Because we are looking at from this angle, this seems to be the bigger landform, but it is not the big or the small, it is just a closer view, and this is a little more distant view. So here these, I'll just pull it up so that you get to see the full picture. And there after I will be just doing some over here. So this here, this place, I will give you the idea of how to make the landforms. You can also make greenery and you can also make it brown, but the shades will follow the same. Now already lots of greens and blues have been added in the peacock. So to get the visual appeal of it, I would take a browner tone for this. So I'll take this as green and this as brown. So I'll be preparing my colors right in front of you. This is the palette. I've not washed it. I don't generally, because sometimes I have to pick the already existing colors and shades. So here. Some blue. So this blue and red, giving it a little purple. Little green. So it is a very dark shade of green, very dark, and then a little bit of yellow. So I've got a very muddy color. So this is a brown shade that I've received, and this is the dark concentrated color, and this when diluted with white, I'm getting this. These grades, how to work on the shade making, that is also very important. I would suggest that you take a bigger plate, okay, and then take out your main colors there. So if I say red, yellow, black, white, take it like that, pull little bit from everywhere, and then you will make the color. Do not just pile up making one color. What you have to do is you have to keep the concentrated color there with you. So as in when you want to make the shade, you will be adding different colors to make it. Coloring peacock, it would be helpful. Mehak, yesterday's video, if you just check, it is all about the peacock. So we did that already yesterday. So that is the day three. Now here, I'm doing the bottom with this brown, the darker one. This is how we go ahead with this. Now on the top, I'll just zoom it a little and show it to you. Here. So right now you don't have to go very refined on this. Just do a base color. So here I'm just mixing the colors a little red in this shade, and I'm keeping all my treasures. I call them all treasures because these colors are all very, very useful. You have a reddish tone, you have a white, more whitish tone, you have a dark one, and then you have the concentrated form that you have made. You will gradually add the colors to do the. Now I'm adding the lighter version here and just blend. Just rub it 2-3 times while your color is wet, and then you will get a smooth blend. So what you can see here is a reflection. It's the light is getting reflected with the water. Once it's dry, you will get the whole idea about it. Now I'm taking just a white in the same existing brush, not washed, not wiped, because it already has that color, and just with a little bit of wipe. So this is the area where the light is being hitting onto the higher point. So this is the depth and this is the higher points. Creating the same over here. You can also do with greens. And now, since all the colors we have it ready in the palette, you need to pick from wherever you want to. Darker tones, medium tones, and lighter tones. With all these three, just blend it softly and you're ready with this. Again, going on to the darker. So this is a repetition, of course, but after this I will be adding some details with black. So do not create a stenciled effect. So when I say that stenciled effect is that we do not have to copy the same shade everywhere. So the shade work will change accordingly. Some can be lighter or darker. Okay, so it's not that all of it has to be the same. I'll just give you a little bigger view of this. So here it's not too much of value here. Just the base. So here. So this is a place, actually a creek kind of a thing, where the water is flowing and then going as a source to the and this Kamal Talai. So here I will again make a little bit of shade of the waters, and I'll help you with the how to do the waters. That'll help be a good help. So here, first thing, how to make the this water, which I've already done. I'll show it in front of you. Here, I don't have much place to collect. Okay, I'm taking white. I'm taking a little bit of blue to get the sky blue kind of the color. And I'm taking a very small tint of black that I have. Okay, already picking it up from this and then mixing it. You will get a beautiful gray color. Not very... The tone of the gray is on the blue side. So I'm mixing a little bit blue to get blue and black to give it a darker tone. So here. So here, once it is coming from a distance, we will see that the darker color is more for that. And just make three values here. So a little bit black and blue. And a little white from here itself. So you will see how I'm mixing the colors and getting all of it. Shouldn't be very gray, like a dull one. Do add blue tint to it. So I've got two shades. One is light and one is dark. Now I'll be doing the waters here. Now there are two ways. First you do the light one and then you give the dark lines or the highlight. You can do one by one, but if you are good with handling two brushes, You can always work with two brushes. So I'll just take the green here. Now taking the lighter color. This is a flat brush and I'm just going it in this fashion where it creates that the effect of ripples. My brush had already a little bit of green in it. So just with the force, I'm pulling that, and in the center there is light and the corners are darker. So such kind of work, if you create, you can also layer it with, ma'am, can we use watercolors or acrylic? You can use anything. Right now here what I'm using is the poster color and I have only a pack of six. So with a very limited color palette also, you can make your shades. So if you want to do it with acrylic, that is also okay. If you want to do it with watercolors, that's okay. I prefer poster colors because poster colors are very opaque. But if you are doing it on a fabric, definitely you will have to go for a acrylic. Just adding those gray. You'll give the highlights with pure white. I'm not getting very close to this because my black is still wet. The live sessions don't give you much scope of waiting for your paint to dry. So I'm just leaving. You will see that I'm leaving a little crease for the wet areas. And then later here. Now since I will be doing this lily in I'll be coloring this. I will just do the gray to the background. I will be creating another batch of color again because my color is all exhausted. So now here already I have this concentrated shade and I just need to add a little white and pick it here. It's all ready. So never let go with your concentrated color. And when we are doing waters, it's very important for us to note the strokes. We are not going like up and down, standing strokes. No, it's all in a horizontal manner. This is just the water. I'll give you a little idea. Let my paper absorb a little bit of color and it dries. Meanwhile, if you have any queries, you can please put it up and I'll answer all of it. You're waiting for it to dry, but still I'm giving some very fine shades of water here with the same darker color, and while it's wet I'm just giving it a very feathery kind of look, so the strokes are having very light ends on either side, so it's not like a line which is like this. So do not make a line like this. This is a wrong approach for it, but if in case it happens, just go and feather it out on both the sides. So your soft blends will help you. Do not let it dry that way. So before you want it to dry, you want to achieve that look that you want for your picture. So these are few places here I'm giving, and I will be giving the darker on the exterior side of the picture so that my main focus of the brightness stays to the center. These are the few things which, when we are painting the elements, we focus on the elements and not the total form of it. But when you look at the Pichhwai, you will see that there is a grading from the background, wherein the sky is getting darker towards light and the ground is also getting darker to light, and mostly the shades of light are in the middle of the painting. So this is not on the this is seen in Pichhwai when you have a lot of perspective, not the kind where we'll have only Shrinathji or the cows, where there is a scenery or a garden, or wherever you see the horizon, the sky, the waters, the land, you will see that this is happening. Here I'm just giving a small, yeah, okay, the subscribe button came here. So if you've not done it, please subscribe the channel and share it with others as well. Some places here, if in case, I'm just taking a little lighter tone and doing the same. This work needs a lot of patience, so do not rush. Do not rush on this. Create your values and only leave when you are happy. I'll wait for it to dry now almost, and then I will be starting with the next level of it. I'm giving it a darker boundary for the flower. So this, wait till it dries. And ma'am, how do you know so many art forms? Okay, Chantan. When you will be practicing it every day, it's just that when you are too keen to know things, you are hungry for more all the time, you'll definitely grow up in your knowledge and practice. So a little hard work will always help you to do it. So there's a lot of study. I'm not from any region where, when I do Pichhwai, that doesn't mean I'm from Rajasthan. When I do Patachitra, that doesn't mean I'm from Orissa or any specific place. So it is only your interest into the art form which pulls you, the attraction towards how the things are made, first thing. When you get so curious and you want to do it, and you while you do it, you start appreciating and you indulge in the art. When you do that, you know more about it, you research a lot, and then you learn it. So all the best. So we'll continue. I am waiting for it to dry a little. So many smileys, Chandan. I thought it made you happy. Okay. Yeah, I took a little bit of white here. Now the lower portions are still wet. As you can see, the colors are shining, the water is shining back, and I'm giving a little bit of the shine or the light that's falling on it, giving it a dry brush effect. When you create a dry brush effect, you have very rough lines and very spaced out lines, I would say. Okay, so do not take too much of water in it. Only the tip of your brush will go. So if I have this hand over here, you will see only this much would go. Only this much. Do not press your brush. Okay, don't press your brush, and then you will be able to work on it. If initially your lines will look very opaque and white, but as soon as it dries, you will see that they give you a little bit of, they're not that bright. And when this happens, you can always layer it up to your desire. Okay, so the shades are your grades. Okay, how you want to grade your picture, how dark or light, or how contrasting or how subtle colors you want to use. So now here I'm taking black, which is just pure black. It's already here, and not too much water, because then it'll be very runny, and I'll be creating this. The contrast gets really high. I'm not doing any black on the top because that is the place where the light is hitting. So just go with this and you can create the look of the second also. Like these, the creases that are there, that will give you a different. So like this is the a little more detail work. It will just pull out your landforms separate from your waters. Now with the same dark, I'm just taking the same black that I'm just making it a little more watery and runny and just giving it a fine lines on the other side. And this, I'm doing it the distant corners so that the focus is in the middle. And there's the shadow. Here, the more you want to create life in your picture is the more you want to see it like real. So I'm adding the darkness beneath the bird also so that my bird gets most of the focus. You can make different things. You can make swans here. You can make small lilies or lotuses that are already there. So here, see. So this you will get. This was the whole picture. It's only the one side that I'm working on. A little more black to do the a little bolder line for my peacock so that it doesn't get mixed up at all. So this is here. This is the thing that I wanted to show. Still, this area will be completed with black only after the flower is done, because these are poster colors and they are soluble. When the water comes in touch of it, the black will might just bleed to the other side. I don't want to take chances on that. So after completion of this only it will be done. But I've already done video, and in the previous class also we have done this lily, so I think that will not be a problem. You can just repeat the same kind, or maybe you can use a pink lotus. That is your wish, whatever you want to do. Okay, now here I will be doing few of the plants. They're very important because perspective, definitely it gives you a lot of area to see the greenery. And of course when there is a something like a peacock, definitely there has to be either a parapet of a palace or something like that where they climb, or else they will have the place which is very green. So let's study the palette first. And here I'm just taking my flat brush and doing a very dark color of green here, this area. So I'll do the dark color here, and for that I'm taking the green and I'll be taking blue. Green blue will give me a little darker tone and mix with a little black. So this is the color. So green, blue and a little black is giving me this color, which will be the base of the tree. So if you want, you can sketch out the tree. I'll just keep the line very crisp on this side because that will be the border. We will do the border later. So when you drag the color, you actually see what all pigments are there. See, so it's coming out beautifully, right? So there's a lot of grade. The camera, I don't know if you're able to see that or not. Here, okay. So I'm just giving this den, this area as the darker area, as I was, I told you when we were doing the waters also, I wanted to keep the distant areas like this side of it darker. Okay, so the lighter shades will come onto this side because the light is coming here. So there's a lot of understanding on the light and depth that is involved in any of the picture. You will get it with the, now here I'm not giving it a very fine fine wash. I'm just going around and creating quite circles or C's, whatever it is, like this. So it's the dark color that I'm adding. Some places my dark will be even darker. So a little uneven color will actually add to the beauty, because what will happen is you can actually differentiate between bunches of different plants. You can do overlapping. So here I'm creating a little darker one for this area. Taking just the bright green. So my colors are really not, so you get this effect you can create by just tapping on it also. Just take the desired color and tap, and you will get this kind of a bunch. I'm pulling the colors down. You might have to redo the same shade again. So I'm doing it in batches here. And my color gets a little bit of shade difference in greens, and I'm really happy about it. Because then in that way, you will create different types of plants. So what I will be doing here is I will give a tall tree, maybe a medium-sized tree or a smaller one, so that you get the variation in different kinds of tree patterns and the bush systems, different kind of leaves and those things that can be made. So I'm just saving my lotus here. So this is just a wash, and apply a very thin coat because then you want it to dry very quickly. Like this. I will be taking just black and doing it under the bird. Okay. Oops, sorry. It's out of focus, so sorry about it. Here. Like this. My skies will be a little dusky, I would say. And I'll create a color for that till this is drying. Now I need a very fresh palette for that. And where is my palette? So the Kamal Talai that I was doing, I was using this palette. Now when I'm doing this, I'm using this palette. So whenever I paint, I keep my colors safe. And so just have a couple of more handy so that you do not have to wash your palette before you finish the painting. So anyway, I'll be just doing the sky, and this is a palette that will help me to do the sky because it has similar colors which I'll be using. I'm using a flat brush, flat brush 6 and the colors are white. I'll take it here, the white, good enough white, little bit of blue, adding this as light, very light blue. Now, how I'll be grading this, I will be starting with the darker color and slowly I will be working towards the light. As are they watercolors? No, Varsha, these are poster colors. So there, poster colors. All are poster colors. You may also use watercolors, but the thing is that the watercolors will have a lot of transparency, whereas poster colors are a little chalky. So I prefer that effect. So I'm just add a little water so that you get the consistency, which is a milk-like consistency, not too pasty. So I added water. You can see that it's flowing. You put a drop here and you will see that it, I don't know if it's visible or not here. So just put a drop and you see that it slowly trickles to the other side. It should not be very runny. Taking a flat brush. A little bit of shade difference will help you, but then if in case the shade difference is happening, try to make it in a way that it suits the sky, because in the sky also it's a big canvas. You see a lot of shapes and forms happening in the sky with clouds and other stuff. So just give it a nice watch, like what is good for your painting. This is a painting that I'm doing from some, just it's out of the imagination, like okay, this element should be there, this element should, mainly focusing on the tutorial where everything can be incorporated in one painting and it passes to you easily and you understand everything in perspective. That's the main idea of creating this picture. So it's not traced, it's not stenciled, it's not transferred, it's just freehand drawing. But yes, if in case you want to trace any picture, of course you can. So here you will see that there are a little bit of effects that you can see with water and paint. So some places it has gone a little lighter, some places darker. I will create more values in this. Now just taking water a little. Water always, if you add, you can only add water to maintain the consistency. Don't add water to create shade. So if in case you take blue and you add water, it will not create a light blue. It will only give a transparency to your blue. So I'm just taking this white, a little bit of blue, and the gray probably, I'll just take it from here. Already it's there, a little bit of more gray. I'm giving it a darker value here and there. So just a few curves here. I'm doing it gray because I want to just show a little bit of darker clouds. Not all will be the same color. And here I'm taking a little bit of white. Again, don't make it very chalky, mix water so to soothe your flow of the brush. giving the same, mixing it. Just give it a little more cloudier effect, but we will just brush out any imperfections. So just go ahead and mix this. We will create one more line work on these clouds once this gets a little absorbed. If in case I want to layer it for that, for the time being, I'll just take my greens. I want to add one more bush over here, which so just a distant one. At this moment, it looks like, okay, it's been just few colors have been placed, but actually it will come out really beautiful when the things are done in detailed form. So here, giving it a more value. So you can create the values by darker to the lighter. I'm adding a darker color here and giving it a little lighter shade on the other side. I'm not doing any detail work right now. It will dry out and then we will create the detailing. Now this portion has already dried and I will be showing you. Thanks, Varsha. Thank you so much. And now I will be doing creating the little detailing on it. So working on the palette again, I have the same palette and I will be adding for the lighter tones, what should I be adding? So here I will switch my brush. I'll take a smaller brush, more pointed, long bristles but pointed. I'm taking white to the yellow. It's already yellow was there. As I will put some water, it will again get diluted and will give its pigments to white. Here again, water in the same place, and a little bit of green, and let's work out on this shade. So they're very light, actually. It's more like yellow only. So I'll add some color, more color, and that's green. Now once you take out the green, I'll just wipe it off at a separate place because I feel it's too much for this. And yes, this is what color is okay. So take a lighter shade, and that's because when you would work on the thing here, you will see that it will bring out the I am just putting few dots in here. So this will tell me where I want to put up my designs. So there are these are like one stroke kind of a work, and I will go from this side to do like this. You can add even lighter color. If you're not happy with this, I'm adding a little bit more white. Or you can also, if you want a very high contrast, you can work on your background as well. If you want to work on your background, you can do it more dark, like a blackish color, and then these will all shine out. Wherever you have those areas, you can just put those bunches, and it's okay if it goes out also, like that. So these are basically the guidelines where you want to make your bush. So here you can also mix a little bit of more light and dark shades to create the values here. I just want to keep it the same color. So these are like a one stroke work. We don't have to work on like we are drawing the leaves and then we are... Thank you, Geeta. So you don't have to draw and color the leaves. It's like just go and do your forceful stroke. Your force in the stroke is what will add beauty to your picture. So just press first and release with a stroke. So you will have a very pointed end. I'm working myself from top to bottom. Now here there is a variation in the shade, and this is a bush that was in a different shade, and now here it is a little bit dark. I want to actually add a little more darkness to this, otherwise it will just go inside, it will be a lot. So I'll just take black here and take black in here, just a little wash on it so that I'm happy with those colors. Really dark bush over here. So now, why am I adding this? Because I want these two to stand very separate, and there will be a difference in the leaf system, the formation of the leaf. And I just did this for this little bush here. I'll wait till it dries. Meanwhile, I'll be a little more on the down portion. It'll take just a moment to dry. And drying is important because it will not mix with the color that you will do over it. So even if it is poster colors, they will take some time to mix with your paint. So don't worry, it'll once dry, you can really work with one stroke. Do not blend too much. If you just go a little to and fro with your brush, definitely it will get mixed up. Now with this, I'm taking the green and the light color that I already had, and I'm just taking this. Now I'll be changing the colors often. I'll take more contrast by adding yellow and white. Just work yourself like this outside. So it's like one flower and then just the other one blooming. So I'll just give it, it's not a very fine, you don't have to match your ends actually. I'll give you a closer view to it. You don't have to match your ends. So do not make it like a pencil drawing or a pen drawing. So here. Just go with the force, do not end, join the ends. So this is how the two bunches will mix together. So it's the total, it's the whole thing in totality that counts a lot. And you may vary in the size, so it's not that all the bunches are of the same size, so you can actually work your way a little bigger or smaller bunch. So here you will see around three or four styles of trees. So in Indian folk arts, there's one thing which is very, very important is the practice of your line work. Indian arts are mostly based on the line drawing. So lines play a lot of role. Make it dense, but then you are just having the idea of where the picture is. So as I change the shade over here, I'll just redo this. We can create flowers and fruits in this, which once the leaf is done, leaves bunches are done, we can do those afterwards. here. With this today's work, after the trees and the clouds and the land, this you can see that the picture is getting in the form, and it's not just the element, just one focus like we are learning about the plant or the lotus or anything. But yes, if you want to do a very simpler version of it, you can use the same element in one or two motifs on the dresses or anywhere you want to use it, you can use it. I'll try to do a picture of Shrinathji on canvas and share with you as a recording. I would be just leaving this, and now the next bush will start from here. You can see onto the different, the other variation of it. I'll zoom it out. Here. So, now here actually when working on this, I will draw a peahen also here. So, because this fellow is going to be very lonely. So I'll just draw. So this, I'll be coloring it later. So I'll just leave that area. You can do a couple of birds. So this is a peahen here. They don't have much design, or they are not as beautiful as a peacock. Now here I'll do a bush with the flowers. I'll show you that. And for this land, I will be following the same brown, because here also it's dark and the lotus pond is also gray. So I will do it like in a barren or a bright green. I'll do that later. Today we will finish off with this bush, and this would finish with our the tree system, how we do. We will do further pictures also. Probably then we can pick on to the other leaves like banana tree or... So here in this, I will take a brown, light brownish peachish shade. I'll change the shade here. With the same color, I'm just mixing a little bit of red and white to give this coral pink and green. So it's a brownish tone that I'll take, or a sap here, sap green white mix. So this is good. You cannot actually define your colors, okay? So you cannot say that this is this kind of a shade, this is that kind of a shade. It's very much to what you desire. You just add a lighter or a darker, or what tone do you want it. You can work on that. Now here I'm doing the... So for the bushes here, I'm making few strokes. They are very thin, hair thin like strokes, very lighter ones. And this way it'll get created here with the same one, giving it a lighter tone now. Again, taking the lighter color and mixing it to get the light one. And here I will be doing press, release, press, release, press, release. So you'll get those leaf kind of shape. It's one stroke only. There is no need of filling the color. So continuously go. And see to it that you get it in a fashion where you're not just making lines. There is a press, so you get a dot, and then you release, you get a drop kind of a shape. And do it close. It's not very important that these center lines should be seen. So I made it as a guideline, and I'll be just working myself down on this. You can do a little overlap, and that's okay, because there is no boundary. They are just overlapping each other. Different sizes can also work, but yes, we cannot go very huge on the size because these are little bushes. Okay, Prerna Singh. I learned many things by you. Thank you, ma'am. Oh, it's my pleasure. And you can give it a twist also. Don't make it very upright. So here, if you see, you can bend your bushes nicely like this. The more you do, the more space you have, you will get the idea of how to do it. I'll just zoom it a little so that it's easier and more comprehensive to you. Yeah. And it's not one shade that I'm picking. I'm just sometimes picking my lighter shade and just again tapping it on the same so that I get a little variation. As when you see these bushes or anything, you will see that in the tree, in one tree, you will have so many shades. It's about the age of the leaf. They will change the color. So even all are from the same plant doesn't mean that they all will be same color or the same size. So the basically form will be the same. You can add it. So you can actually see my palette also, because many a times I have received questions like what shade, and it gets really very tricky to tell what shade, because I really work my shade out with this. So it's not a bottled color that you get. You have to mix your basic colors to get the shade. I'm taking a little bit of green, probably from here, anywhere. So now when you will have such colors, you can actually rebuild on your picture. So if I take a really lighter shade, as in these are very small things that you would, it's better if you understand. So here I'm taking this. If I want to do a little bit more lighter shade, I'm taking a little bit white here, and I can work one more bush over all the leaves that are there. So overlapping can be done. Here, see, I overlapped from this, and this shaft, this stick that I already made is not really showing full. Like that. Here also. Now I'll just give you the little idea of how do we work on the plants on the other side. This is here. The same. Now you have to see what color looks beautiful over here. I still have to do my bases, but still if I'm telling you this, I'll want to tell you this as well. So take your lines here and you can do the same thing on this. So you don't need a perfect bush base color also. Such details will come over anything. So it is poster color, but it is not mixing with anything. So one stroke will not harm your background color or will mix with any shade. So here, like this way, small strokes for grass will be just this. So this is the stroke for grass. Here I'm taking a little white and green together. So these are the leaf blades here. So I'm doing it at the edge of the land here. You can work yourself in the middle of the thing. So for very distant trees, if I want to make it, I will not be making any of the bushes. I will be just doing a little bit a dabbing over here, taking a darker shade. So how to create those also, very distant, very, and just tap it. It should actually show that, fine, you have some tree system over there, fine. One side lighter, one side darker, depending on where the light is coming from. Now, since it's very small and the color is getting all, it's shining back because of the light, you're not able to see, but by the time we'll end the class you will be able to see this. So just tap it on and then you will. You can make these small kind of things to just make your picture look beautiful. Now for the flowers, we don't do much actually. So it's like a dot or something that'll work. And take the dark color. So when you will see your poster colors, you'll see that it gets sedimented down. Sedimented means all the thicker portions, thicker pigments will be down. So you have to actually churn it to get the darker colors because it is all settled here. It's lumpy on the inside here. So just take out those bright, thick pigments. And then you can, here also you can add a small, maybe red or anything. This will brighten up your picture. If you want to do this, good enough. If you want to leave it, you can use any colors, yellows or whites or anything. I'm just taking a red one because my picture doesn't have any, not much red. So like this. Here also with the bushes. Just giving few dots on the end of the lines. Don't worry on the formation of it. Just kind of weeds growing with flowers, wild flowers. You may create shades in this as well. I'll just show you at places. So all the reds is done and now I'll just give it a little hint with the white, or so that You may want to do it with yellow also, or any color, blue flowers, red flowers, orange flowers, any flowers you can do. Whatever you feel that, okay, this, I want to do this. You can do many also. Not every place I'm adding the same. So this is what is giving a little perspective to your picture here. I hope you liked it all. Thank you, Vaishali. So this, but yes, due to the time constraint, we are already running out of time. So most 1 hour is over that we were doing it. So this is what is the perspective of here. And then I will be giving you a quick this here. So this is the Kamal Talai that was already done here. And this is the beauty of how later on also you can also build your more lines. You can revisit your picture and do more fine work. Definitely, if you go for a very big picture, by the time you end your picture, you will have beautiful control on your hand, on your stroke, understanding of your shades and consistencies, which is very, very important. Yes, Vaishali. Any color depends on what you want to add. So this red, you can actually add yellow also. So here it is a very olive green kind of a thing. You can actually do it over black. When you do it black also, it looks very beautiful. Here also, in this, you can add different colors. So maybe a yellow, where I have put those dots, you can put a yellow or a white. That will also look nice. It totally depends on how heavy you want to make your picture look, right? I hope you all liked it. And if any questions, just please write it. And I will just quickly try to answer all of it. And thanks for sharing your weekends with me. Okay, anybody has a question? So detailing is totally up to you. How much more detailing you want to do or you don't want to do. If in case you want to just make one motif, you can do it. So don't feel that, okay, Pichhwai is very, very elaborate and we have to end up doing so much. You don't have to. It's not a necessity, but it's just your way of looking at it. If you want it like that, do it. So it's not that we have to have one Pichhwai in our house. No, it's not. It's just about how much you indulge into the art, how much you know it, how much passionately you want to do it, and how happy you feel with every stroke that you do. So it's a self-love. Painting or drawing is your self-love. Thank you, Geeta. So everybody, take out the time for yourself. Take out a few pencils, paints, what have been lying down here, there, and start painting and be creative. And I'll be with you every weekend with the live session and few of the videos also. I don't post many videos actually because I don't get time with out of my private classes also. So it's only the weekends that I get it for the live sessions, and I really want to share it with all of you. So thank you for connecting. And all your love. Thank you. I'll see you next week.